Many people feel that something else is possible in their life, but they don't know what it is. They know that they should move, but they don't know how to move. They know they have been in that state long enough, and now they're ready to explore new dimension. Because we create the life we live in. We create the body we live in. We create the mind we live in. So it's in our hand to create a fuller, richer, more harmonious life. In my experience, Gurdjieff movement can be a powerful tool towards more clarity, towards the opening of dormant possibilities in us, towards the fulfillment of our potential, towards love, towards friendliness. We can see the process as happening in three phases interacting with each other. At first, we develop the sun energy, which is the force of action. By sun energy, we mean that we learn to get in contact with our vital force, to channel it, to let it be manifested outwardly with passion and totality. And one of the manifestations is through these clear-cut movements and dances with precise forms, tempos, and rhythm. At first, we tend to get carried away by the movement. Giving ourselves totally to them, we forget to watch. Then, by and by, we start to return to ourselves. The movement transits from the sun energy into moon energy. More calm, collected, cool, and receptive. We learn to gather an energy which is most of the time dispersed, to collect it in the belly, from where we are able to know the whole mechanism of the body. We develop our sensitivity to the subtleties of the movement. We feel moved by the force of the movement. We do not move, we are moved. We feel intimately in synchronicity with the music, with other participants, and we feel carried. We feel like melting with music, with the atmosphere. We intuitively feel. The fact that we are practicing regularly within a group for a longer period of time allows us to dive deeper inside the movement and inside our own being, and to let the personality melt in the bigger picture of the force field of the group, where everyone finds his role, his place, and his contribution. Star becomes stronger. What is the polar star? I am here using the words talked by Patanjali, the founder of yoga. The polar star is the symbol of something absolutely unmoving. Somewhere in us, there is no movement, there is eternity. The watcher is the polar star. The watcher is the only thing which is unmoving. Emotion, stress, fear, anger, joy, hope, all of this is constantly moving. Thoughts are flying by, the body is movement. So what is the thread that holds all these changes? The watcher, who is able to see what is happening without being caught up by all these events. So we establish in Earth a very stable center of gravity. And by, the practice brings us to such an inner stillness that it cannot be disturbed so easily by outer and inner happenings. So in fact, the practice is to transcend the sun and moon phases and to establish more strongly the phase of the polar star, being in action, being in the world, but not identified with all the events. The bigger part of ourselves is anchored in the watcher. Up to now, we have lived mostly through the intellect, and we have forgotten the wisdom of our heart and our body. Let us bring them back together, joining these three centers, so we come to totality and unity, bringing the sacredness in our daily life. Thank you.